single.
Yeah, you gotta. You can't just switch. Because otherwise, so these two players would agree to just switch to Shovel Knight right now, and they would both play, and then one of them would win the money. So instead, the rules are you have to play Shovel Knight the whole tournament. We've had some top players practicing. I've seen on their streams. I know Windows and Penguin have both been labbing their Shovel Knights up, but no one has taken it out at a major yet. I know there's talk of using it in the online major coming up in December.
We'll find out when that time comes. Anyway, Grand Finals, maybe set one of two, given the track record of these two players, is going to be starting up. It's interesting, just within the season, just the past two tournaments, watching how the matchup has evolved between these two players. Because in their first set at Smash and Splash, we had Penguin slow down the tempo a bit, especially hunt out a really ground-based game. But then in response to that, at SmashCon, we had Kegasol answer back by playing the most conservative neutral ever and just constantly force Penguin to come in and punish him time and time again to get a 6-0 win at that event. But right now, they're just both swinging really hard for the fences.
Yeah, dead even now. That first KO by Cake was just a really good upward combo to manage to get the back air to kill off the top.
Mm-hmm. There we had both players opting to camp, and I think Penguin made the calculation of, I don't want to let any more of the smoke spread. So he's the one who's like feeling the pressure to go in and disrupt Cake Assault's like construction right now.
Yeah, so Forsberg not really considered a zoner by any means, but definitely has the tools to kind of work against zoners, and Clone is his own kind of projectile in some regards.
Yeah, and there's always that intimidation of like, he can build up a full combust, and then from there, he gets the smoke screen to really help his recovery, or he can kill you off really early confirms,
as
we've seen
today.
Oh, man,
Penguin just found him. But yeah, you're exactly right. The combust also, too. He has tools to deal against zoning, and then he can do a little bit of zoning himself.
Mm-hmm.
And he's got those big hitboxes to use Disjoint for the medium range. And there we go. Oh, my gosh.
These guys have not been able to keep a stock lead against each other for more than 10 seconds.
No.
To start off. I mean, it just goes to show they are the number one doubles team. They are practice partners with each other, best friends through and through. It's not really a surprise that they're able to keep such a close pace with each other because they just know each other that well.
But when you came in the door, you said that these two were the two practicing.
Yeah,
against each other.
Everyone else was preparing for the matchup they had to play next in top 8. They just played each other.
Yeah, they're like, we're going to run into each other eventually, so we might as well get warmed up. And Penguin taking game one.
Pretty solid with the fair string.
That last stock, as much as that set was back and forth, the last stock definitely went in Penguin's favor.
Mm-hmm. So it looks like Penguin's been since SmashCon, rather, has been spending some time thinking about, like, all right, when the time comes where Kegasol is just doing nothing, I do need to find ways to open him up, just like with my own approach, either just calling out how he's going to try to escape me or finding a way to bait out his own swatting attempt at me so then I can just, like, punch him in the face right afterwards. We'll see if that continues to pay out, though. This is still a best of five, and Kegasol, like, we've seen him drop one game already, right? And then afterwards, he just completely steamrolled. So
yeah,
the journey's not over yet, not by any means.
Once again, we're going the character switch. This is interesting that we haven't seen it before because other players generally pull out the Zetterburn for Penguin.
Mm-hmm.
Cake, on the other hand, usually goes with his tried and true Forsburn.
Yeah. But especially after the success he just found against ZB using the Zetterburn, I have a feeling that boosted his confidence on top of just the fireball being so challenging for Absa to get around. Because we've seen Penguin lose to other Zetterburns. He lost to Fullstream Zetterburn at Genesis, and he also has dropped a set to Audi Zetterburn. I think it was like a 3-0 as well.
Yeah.
This could be the wave.
The big thing, though, that Cake is going to have to be careful about is, oh, goes for a shine there instead. I think he could have just, he had him on fire. He probably didn't know how long it was going to last. But the big thing is going to be the recovery. Like,
yeah.
Penguin is not, like, ZB had times where he started to drop and Cake was able to get back. I can't imagine Penguin is going to allow Cake back very often.
Yeah. The fact that Cake managed to sneak by there was impressive. But even after sneaking back to stage, Cake was still stuck to those platforms. And then you have to worry about Absa up air after that. It's just one trial after another once you finally get picked off the ground by this character.
And right there, using the
pressure off that platform, not only getting the spike, but afterwards getting the forward air.
Using the down special too and on that platform is so smart. He used it as a movement option to get there, but he also leaves fire, and that's the path that Penguin wants to take with his up special.
Yeah. Because he's looking to get those edge cancels so that he's not in landing lag. But of course, Keiko Salt knows that, so he's making that path as hazardous as possible. He's chilling on those exact same platforms.
Almost killed Penguin.
Beautiful back air right after that recovery. And here we go, the minefield of Penguin.
Ooh.
That's all you need. Just
looked like he wanted to get a wall attack. Maybe wasn't quite on the wall.
Yeah. That absolutely makes sense, because that's what everybody's been doing to try to survive against Penguin there. Oh, catching the air dodge. In a tough position, but Cake calmly finds his way down to that platform.
Oh, goes for the up strong. That was the best option, too. Even though down strong, you're pretty close to the blast zone against someone like Abso or Raster. If you can, oh my gosh.
The double kick again, and Penguin up 2-0. He's the one on the winner side. He can actually take this whole tournament right now. Just one more win against Cake Assault. The Zetterburn was looking pretty good, especially in the things that it was able to keep Penguin from doing, right? Like, we saw almost no quick attacking in neutral, and part of that was Cake Assault will periodically just toss the fireball between all the platforms. And that kind of active obstacle to maneuver around with quick attack on top of the opponent maybe hitting you would be a little bit too much, but since he lost with the Zetterburn, and this might be the final game he gets to play this tournament, Cake Assault going to go with Old Familiar, go back to his Forsburn, and see what
I think
he can do.
I think it's a good swap, especially with just how dominant Cake's Forsburn can be. And I also think the Zetterburn last game was half was doing really well, half Cake, and then half the stage choice was such a big part of it. He was really taking advantage of where the platforms were and kind of the space that Penguin had to work with.
Both like with his own recovery and in terms of just shutting down quick attacks. But going to Treetop right now, a very tight stage in terms of the real estate, but very large blossoms at the same time. Might be able to help Cake keep the gap close between these two characters, while still be able to get that survivability of a huge blast zone, but we'll see whether or not he can actually close out these stocks, because right now Penguin's still alive at 130%.
Yeah, Cake has landed a lot of like semi-kill moves this stock already, but hasn't been able to get one close enough to a blast zone to finish him off.
After that nair, you saw like Cake actually double back on that platform. I think he expected Penguin to immediately try to land, but Penguin kept his cool, stayed in the air, and now sitting in a great position, finding the up air, getting the kill, even though he's at 160%.
Manages to take the first stock there.
And otherwise, oh, wow, that was just the down air. Just finally the sour hit doing the drop center stage. Completely even otherwise.
And Cake, finally able to close that one out. I think we saw a little bit of like a Marthritis going on where he wasn't able to get the KOs into combos, and Penguin was able to take the first stock because of that.
Mm-hmm. The cloud setup, but wow, what a great use of your own teleport body, catching Penguin off guard. Normally he's able to parry that consistently.
I think the clone,
another snipe. And that's a full stock lead now for Penguin on his tournament game. He just needs one more Forsburn stock and he can wrap up his cleanest tournament win yet.
And like we said, Cake on last stock is a whole nother beast, but right now he's in such a big hole. He's on last stock on loser side. Down 2-0.
Trying to take his time, but Penguin seizes the ground floor in the meantime, has managed to anti-air this Forsburn. There we go, the delay,
that parry
not even
is huge.
Enough. There we go, that could be
that's
it.
That's it. Oh, no,
the
wow,
bear,
the
just a little foot. That's all he needed to stay alive. Cake Assault holding on for dear life.
Penguin with great DI. That could easily just swung the momentum in Cake's favor.
This is so scary. Caught off stage, 120%. But once again, the clone being just the little X factor that he needs, getting the tech off a jab. Penguin having so much more patience.
That's
now.
It.
That's the stall he needed. Penguin finally spot lightning kick, taking out Cake Assault with a 3-0 victory on winner's side.
And then the awkward handshake to end it perfect. Wouldn't it be rivals? It's beautiful.
Between those two guys, especially.
But Cake was obviously flustered because he's not used to, you know, having to do the handshake from the losing side. So
exactly. Normally he gets the reset at least.
Yeah, he has to win, so he just gets to decide. So there, it was a little awkward for him. And Penguin, this for the second time this year, the second major, able to take it over Cake, and all of a sudden,
Penguin's the favorite for number one right now.
Yeah,
with
the
that.
Script is flipping.
Exciting. I like that nobody gets to sit on the throne of number one for very long here at Rivals. Like, each person has like a year at most.
Yeah.
And then it's time for the next person in the line of succession to just kind of stab you in the back.